From Johannesburg, South Africa.
Hello.
So I grew up in a very musical family. Everyone in my family sort of sang. My aunts and my mother were all opera singers. So I grew up around choirs, really. And so my initial education in music was in choral music. So I'm talking about sort of Western choral music, like Handel and Mozart and Haydn, and also more South African compositions as well. So I grew up sort of singing that kind of music, and then when I became a rebellious teenager, I discovered rock and roll, and I sort of left choral music behind for a while and picked up the guitar and started writing my own music. We go in packs of twos and threes. We the diseased owls, dwelling in the dark rooms. Come inside, they'll say. Come inside, they'll coax. There's a net up ahead to seal in the sin. The first kind of pop music that I knew was pop music from the 70s. I mean, I remember, and I always tell the story, but I had a friend sleeping over at my house, and he said, let's play some music. And I said, of course. So I went to the radio system, and I put on the OJs, and he was like, what is this? And I said, well, this is the kind of music I listen to when I'm at home. And at that time, sort of rap music in the 90s was really, really huge, and he was very obsessed with Eminem, who I, first of all, didn't know. And then when I did know, I didn't like, because the only music I listened to at that time was Diana Ross and Marvin Gaye and the OJs and the Manhattans. And then I discovered Joni Mitchell and Radiohead and Sonic Youth and punk bands. Yeah. I was acting in musicals all the time, and then when I was in high school, the school didn't have music as a subject, so I sort of I'm transferred to drama. After high school, I went to study music and acting at art school, and that's also when I bought a guitar, and that's when I started writing music, and I started playing really bad, sort of dingy, grungy clubs, and it took a long, long time actually. I got signed when I was 25. And that's about 4 years ago, and that's when I started playing quote-unquote professionally. 2 years ago, I released an EP that was sort of based around a lot of brass instruments. So around the time that I was touring the EP, I had two brass sections. But normally I'm just by myself with a guitar, a keyboard, a laptop, and loop station, and a few microphones. So it makes my life easier. And to be honest with you, I was sort of influenced by Laurie Anderson. Who I was like, if Laurie Anderson can do it, I should probably take a lesson from her. And I just on some level, there came a point in my life where I started disliking bands because I associated them with sort of like very hyper-masculine straight guys. So I wanted to represent my music in a different way than that.
The morning was marvelous fresh, as if it were given to children prodigal in its light. The city loomed behind us, and I stood on the balcony, a blind mole just wondering about, just wondering about. The city has been loving in the morning, it's brutal.
You know, it's interesting because I'm the kind of person who tries not to be nostalgic. I don't look back much. I look back a lot, but I try to stay in the present. But I've got a new album coming out in a few months, either this year or early next year, and I want to work on another book, and maybe another film, because I've acted in a film called The Wound. And I published a novel almost two years ago. So, I mean, once I'm finished with the album and I've toured it and the cycle is over, I'm probably gonna start working on another novel. Yeah. That's my future. Life is really short and long at the same time, and I think people need to start loving each other a little more. I know it probably sounds trite, but I think we're living in a really strange time where we're trying to divide ourselves into little camps and hurt one another. I mean, of course, we can't run away from what has happened, and people need to acknowledge what they've done, like in terms of colonialism, etc., etc. But I think human beings need to be more compassionate and more empathetic with one another. That's all I can say.
Thank you very, very much.